Hi, I'm Dr. Kristi Smock. I'm an associate professor of pathology at the University of Utah School of Medicine and medical director of the Hemostasis Thrombosis Laboratory here at ARUP Laboratories. I'm going to spend the next few minutes discussing laboratory testing for heparin-induced thrombocytopenia with particular focus on the serotonin release assay. What is heparin-induced thrombocytopenia, or HIT? HIT is a syndrome that occurs in a few percent of patients who receive heparin. It is caused by IgG antibodies directed against complexes of heparin and platelet factor 4 that activate platelets, leading to thrombocytopenia and thrombosis. Not all antibodies that form in response to heparin platelet factor 4 complexes are capable of causing HIT, and most patients who develop these antibodies do not develop the HIT syndrome. How is HIT diagnosed? HIT is a clinicopathologic diagnosis. Thrombocytopenia that develops 5 to 10 days after initiation of heparin therapy is often the first clue observed clinically. If HIT is suspected, there are clinical scoring systems, such as the 4T scoring system, that can be used to assess the pretest probability of HIT. Clinical scoring systems consider factors such as presence and timing of thrombocytopenia, presence of thrombosis, and other potential causes for thrombocytopenia. Clinical scoring systems have been shown to have good negative predictive value, but poor positive predictive value. Patients with moderate or high clinical probability of HIT often require laboratory testing to complement the clinical impression and assist with diagnosis. What laboratory tests are available for HIT? There are two general types of laboratory tests for HIT: immunoassays and functional tests. HIT immunoassays are ELISA tests that detect heparin platelet factor 4 antibodies. The ELISA assays are sensitive for HIT antibody detection, but have poor specificity for clinical HIT because they're incapable of determining whether the antibodies have platelet-activating properties. However, the specificity of HIT ELISAs is improved if the optical density, or OD value, is considered, since higher OD values are more likely to represent pathologic antibodies capable of platelet activation. HIT functional assays, such as the serotonin release assay, or SRA, have similar sensitivity but greater specificity than ELISAs because they do evaluate the platelet-activating properties of the antibodies. What is the serotonin release assay, abbreviated SRA? The SRA is considered the gold standard laboratory assay for HIT due to high sensitivity and specificity. The SRA is often used to further evaluate an unexpected ELISA result or to confirm positive ELISA results. The test involves incubating patient serum with washed donor platelets and heparin. The reaction is performed twice, once in the presence of therapeutic heparin concentrations, or low-dose heparin, and once in the presence of a supertherapeutic heparin concentration, which is called high-dose heparin. HIT-positive sera result in platelet activation and platelet granule release in the presence of low-dose heparin. Platelet-dense granules contain serotonin, and release of serotonin into the reaction supernatant is used as a marker of platelet activation. At ARUP, released serotonin is identified and quantified by high-performance liquid chromatography. The results are expressed as percent release, which indicates the percentage of total platelet serotonin that was released. Platelet activation is defined as 20% or greater serotonin release. Platelet activation in positive samples is inhibited in the reaction containing high-dose heparin because the platelet-activating immune complexes, which consist of heparin, platelet factor 4, and IgG antibodies, are disrupted by excess heparin. This inhibition of platelet activation by high-dose heparin in positive samples improves the specificity of the reaction, since other types of platelet-activating antibodies, such as HLA antibodies or platelet autoantibodies, are not impacted by changes in heparin concentration. SRA testing results consist of four components: percent serotonin release in response to low-dose heparin, percent serotonin release in response to high-dose heparin, a qualitative result, which would be positive, negative, or indeterminate, and an interpretive comment. Now we'll talk specifically about interpretation of SRA results. SRA testing results should always be correlated with clinical findings. A result is classified as positive if there is greater than or equal to 20% serotonin release in the presence of low-dose heparin and less than 20% serotonin release in the presence of high-dose heparin. A positive result supports a diagnosis of HIT. A negative result, demonstrates less than 20% serotonin release in the presence of both low and high dose heparin. With negative results, a diagnosis of HIT is unlikely. A result is classified as indeterminate when a specimen causes platelet activation, or greater than or equal to 20% serotonin release at both the low and high heparin concentrations. These specimens may contain preformed immune complexes or non-HIT platelet antibodies, such as anti-HLA or anti-platelet glycoprotein antibodies. An indeterminate pattern is not consistent with a diagnosis of HIT, but in this case, the diagnosis cannot be completely excluded. More information about HIT and HIT testing can be found on our website at www.arupLab.com.